Okay, in this video, I will go through some problems. So you can go to D2L chapter website. You will see the three problems of transmit sort of linear programming. And the Bindley Corporation rental case cars and industrial packaging solutions. And let's go to the rental car problem first. So click here so that you can access the Excel template. And you will see this Excel. Click the rental car problem. Rental cars is a multi-site car rental company in the city. They have a policy that return the car to the location most convenient for your policy. So that means that the company has to constantly move cars around the city to maintain their required level of vehicle the availability. So here you see that three ABC kind of supplier and D through G customers, and they provide this cost of moving place to place. For example, this $9 indicate the cost from A to D, cost to move from A to D. So there are supplier availability. So A, B, C, they have their own availability to supply, and this is a demand, customer demand. So 50 unit for D and 25 unit for F, something like that. Again, using the Excel solver, we need to find out the minimum moving cost. Okay, so create the two tables, candidate solution table and cost calculation table, and set up the the table so that solver will provide optimal total cost. Again, you need to set the here zero, put the zero. And then use the sum function to sum up these suppliers and then sum up these customers. Okay, then in this cost calculation table, we multiply our moving cost times the unit, right? Cost times unit, and we copy this formula all the way, and we have to use the sum function to sum up this order cost. So that's the our ultimate goal, to find out the total cost, then minimize. Again, go to the data tab, and click solver. And delete, because these are all set up from previous one. And let me delete. So set objective here, you have to set the target cell, which is a G18, and click the minimum, because we are now seeking to minimize the moving cost, and selecting this changing variable cell up to here, right? This C9 through F12. Okay, these cells need to be selected. Then we have to add the two constraints, as I said, two constraints. First constraint is that our total ship, amount to ship, should be equal the customer demands. That's the first constraint. And second constraint is our the capacity of this ABC should be less than equal or does not exceed our current our capacity of this current plant or company does not exceed the supply availability, less than equal to supply availability, and click OK. And two constraints are added. And obviously, we make this option so that our cost may not be negative. And we choose the simplex linear programming as a solving method. And click solve. And now they provide the optimum solution, 720. And keep solution, solver solution, and click OK. Okay, that's the answer for this problem.